الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. روبيلا أند روبيلا فاكسين، I mean روبيلا أند بريفنشن أوف روبيلا، باي بروفيسور محمود هاني سليمان. روبيلا كان ترانسميتد فروم the mother to the fetus. So we here remember other congenital, perinatal, and neonatal viral infections. Intrauterine, rubella, varicella zoster, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, HIV, cytomegalovirus, parvovirus, B19, enteroviruses, HTLV1, Lassa fever, Japanese encephalitis. So all these, the fetus must be protected from getting it from his mother. Perinatal and neonatal viral infections, HIV, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, human herpes simplex, varicella zoster, enteroviruses, HTLV1. Rubella virus is a toga virus, RNA virus, one antigenic type rapidly inactivated by chemical agents, ultraviolet light, low pH, and heat. Pathogenesis of rubella, respiratory transmission of virus, replication in nasopharynx and regional lymph nodes, viremia 5 to 7 days after exposure, with spread to tissues, placenta and fetus infected during viremia. Epidemiology, reservoir human transmission respiratory, subclinical cases may transmit infection, seasonal pattern, peak in late winter and spring, communicability 7 days before to 7 days after rash onset. Infants with congenital respiratory syndrome may shed virus for a year or more. Rubella clinical features, incubation period 14 days, prodrome of low grade fever, rash maculopapular 14 to 17 days after exposure, lymphadenopathy in second week. This is the rash of rubella, begins on face, then spread to body. Maculopapular, not confluent, lasts 3 to 5 days, may be accompanied by coryza, conjunctivitis, and thumb rash on soft palate. This is rubella rash, an erythematous exanthem spreads from hair line downward and clears as it spreads. Rubella case definition, acute onset of general maculopapular rash and temperature more than 37.2 degrees centigrade if measured, and arthralgia or arthritis, lymphadenopathy or conjunctivitis. This is child with exanthem of acute rubella. This is the rash. Rubella complications, arthralgia or arthritis. Adult female up to 70%. The other complications are real, like thrombocytopenia, encephalitis, purpura, neuritis, or orchitis. Congenital rubella syndrome, infection may affect all organs, may lead to fetal death or premature delivery. Severity of damage to fetus depends on gestational age. Up to 85% of infants affected if infected during first trimester. We still within congenital rubella syndrome may include deafness, cataracts, heart defects, microcephaly, mental retardation, bone alteration, liver and spleen damage. also congenital rubella syndrome might be transient, T, permanent, P, and developmental, D, manifestations. These are the common and the uncommon or rare. Please print this table and use it in your hospital or clinic. Risks of rubella infection during pregnancy. The risk depends upon the time during which the fetus is exposed. If the mother exposed preconception, minimal risk. If exposed during the first 12 weeks, it is a 100% risk of fetus being congenitally infected, resulting in major congenital abnormalities. Spontaneous abortion occurs in 20% of cases. Then, between 13 and 16 weeks, deafness and retinopathy in 15%. After 16 weeks, normal development, slight risk of deafness and retinopathy. Congenital rubella syndrome pathogenesis. Rubella virus enters fetus during maternal viremic phase through placenta. Damage to fetus involves all germ layers due to rapid death of some cells and persistent viral infection in others. Chromosomal aberration and decrease in cell divisions are present. Diagnosis of congenital acquired rubella. Rubella IgM in cord blood or serum taken in infancy. This is the most reliable method. Detection of rubella antibodies at a time when maternal antibodies should have disappeared, about 6 months of age from infants. Isolation of rubella virus from infected infants in first few months of life. Rubella lab diagnosis, isolation of rubella virus, positive serologic test for rubella IgM, significant increase in rubella IgG. Prevention of rubella vaccination is the most important way, and there are different strategies. The strategy used in Egypt is to immunize children at 12 months of age. Antenatal screening. All pregnant women attending antenatal clinics are tested for immune status to rubella. Despite vaccine program, about 10% of women reach childbearing are susceptible to rubella infection. Non-immune women offer the rubella vaccine in immediate postpartum period. Women receiving rubella vaccine avoid pregnancy for 28 days after vaccination. Inadvertent rubella vaccine during pregnancy was not associated with any congenital rubella syndrome-like defects. It is not necessary to consider termination. Women attending for antenatal care and unaware of immune status tested for rubella antibodies, if negative, vaccinated immediately postpartum. All healthcare workers should receive MMR vaccine if not immune, either they are male or female. Rubella outbreak control guidelines. Lab diagnosis of rubella and congenital rubella syndrome. Step-by-step guidelines on evaluation and management of an outbreak. Rubella prevention and control among women of childbearing age. Rubella and CRS surveillance. Post-exposure prophylaxis with immunoglobulins. Post-exposure IG does not prevent infection in non-immune contexts, so not recommended for protection of women exposed to rubella. It may decrease symptoms due to decreased level of maternal viremia, and this will lead to decreased fetus risk. Women who contact rubella during first trimester but insist to proceed pregnancy offered human immune globulin or rubella immune globulin. Infants of women with subclinical rubella in early pregnancy after giving them immunoglobulin for rubella are, after giving them human immunoglobulin, are less infected in utero, or if infected, less severely affected. Possible mode of action: decrease maternal viremia, as we just said, due to immunoglobulin. Dose of the immunoglobulin is 1,500 milligram intramuscularly as soon as possible after exposure and 3 days later. Rubella vaccine, the composition: live virus at live attenuated, efficacy 95, duration of immunity lifelong, one or two doses, should be given with measles mumps as MMR or with measles mumps and varicella as MMRV. Indication of MMR: 12 months or above, susceptible adolescents and adults without documented evidence of rubella immunity, emphasis on non-pregnant women of childbearing age. Rubella immunity: documentation of one dose of rubella containing vaccine on or after first birthday. Serologic evidence of immunity: birth before 1957. MMR adverse reactions: fever, rash, joint symptoms. The other are rare, as thrombocytopenia, parotitis, deafness, and encephalopathy. Rubella vaccine arthropathy: acute arthralgia in about 25% of susceptible adult women. Acute arthritis like signs and symptoms occur in about 10%. Rare reports of chronic or persistent symptoms. Contraindication and precautions of MMR: as we said before, severe allergic pregnancy, immunosuppression, moderate or severe acute illness, recent blood product. Vaccination of women of childbearing age: ask if pregnant or likely to become in next 4 weeks. Exclude those who say yes. For others, explain theoretical risk and vaccinate. وفي النهاية لا أجد أن أقول الحمد لله رب العالمين و thank you for your good listening.